Okay, good morning, afternoon, and or evening. Welcome to Moss Book 2. I hope everything's working. A bit of a different setup with VR today, all this time.
We remember you, dear reader.
Where's my headset? Even if
one who could determine all our
fates. Good morning. Whoever you are.
She needs a reader who knows just how important they truly are. Shall we begin?
Yes.
Every war in Moss begins and ends with the five glass. And on the Cinder Knight, the Arcane tried to take...
Stardust. Hello, Stardust.
Sir Argus, commander
Good
of
evening.
The Kingsguard, sacrificed everything that night to ensure the King's Glass was safe. The sprites, too, had their own glass to protect. And their great champion did so until his final breath. Cheers, Neon. The story of his glass would resume much later when young Quill of the Clearing, out on one of her humble adventures, found what the sprite champion concealed in death. When she showed her uncle Argus the green glass, everything changed. He understood well the gravity of her find and rushed off to seek counsel with the sprites. But Argus was captured by the Arcane, and so the starving Adurin came to Quill with a promise to lead her to her uncle. Quill knew of starvings only from campfire tales of magic and mischief. Yet still, she decided to follow. Quill knew her uncle needed her, but not just her. You see, Quill was bonded by the glass to a reader, a soul whose gifts proved the perfect complement to the young hero. Together, they were twofold. They embarked on a perilous journey. The Arcane's pursuit was relentless, and Quill barely survived. Adurin, who had become a friend of sorts, was not as fortunate, ending up in the jaws of Sarfog. Sarfog was the Arcane's most ruthless general, and at the very gates of the castle seized on that Cinder Knight, the twofold heroes slayed the monstrous serpent and rescued Argus from captivity.
So check out where my mic is. That's where my mic is.
But the Arcane do not end with Sarfog. The one who leads them will not relent until the five glass are in their clutches. And that will unravel this world. Our fate rests with Quill. She needs a true partner by her side. And we hope that is you, dear reader.
Yes, it's me.
So let us begin at the castle, where Quill and her uncle must brave the Arcane to retrieve the King's Glass, still hidden away after all these years. Or so they hope.
Whoa, that's bright. Well, I remember this.
You're still here. Then you should have this. You can thank me later. Or maybe before.
Give it.
Who
Quill searched the castle entrance for her uncle's sword. He'd insisted they'd never reach the King's Glass without it. Quill was shocked to find it hiding in plain sight. She must have missed it last time around. After all, she'd been a bit preoccupied.
Together, we can accomplish anything,
said Quill, looking up to her reader.
I couldn't have defeated this monster without you. Thank you for being here with me.
She'd left Uncle Argus alone for too long. He could be in grave danger.
Let's go.
They had to hurry. Her poor uncle was too injured to defend himself should the Arcane find him again.
I kind of want to get these. How do I put my sword away? I don't know. Hear whispering. That's not cool. Okay, what now? Where do I get those things? Oh, there's a button right there. That'll do it.
Uncle Argus. Quill was relieved to find him safe.
You found my sword.
Couldn't believe where it was. You know, I never realized just how huge Zarkbog was.
Shh, lower your voice, Quill. We're not safe. He could be anywhere. The king's glass hides beneath the throne. We must move quickly and quietly. Your reader. Are they still here?
Yes, Uncle. They're right by my side.
So?
We're twofold. We aren't afraid of the Arcane.
I see.
He said with a hint of pride.
Now, keep your ears open and your sword ready. We must get to the throne.
There's a lot of claw marks everywhere. That's not a good sign.
No sign of the Arcane here.
That's what worries me.
Uncle, look out!
That sounds like Stevie.
She's in your hands now.
Oh yeah, that's Stevie. Hey Stevie. Boom.
Quill,
slowly remembering what I'm supposed to do.
Too important to risk yourself for me. The greater good must always come before matters.
How do you guess rolling on the floor laughing?
I'm learning.
That's hilarious.
He always came first. But she knew better than to argue.
Right. Door.
Mm-hmm.
on ahead. I'll stay a few steps behind.
Okay.
You focus on getting to the throne.
Okay. Oh yeah, I can cut grass. It's a real game. Oh, can't cut that grass. Enemies, first enemies. Alright, I've got to remember how to do this. Scroll up there. Yeah. Suburb. No spoilers. Parkour. Okay, we can continue.
I not got round to playing the second one yet, any better than book one.
Well, remember that. Parkour. Okay. What's up? You? Jumpy jumpy over there? Okay. Okay.
Yeah. Quill was awestruck. This was the legendary throne room, the same room where her uncle was once knighted by the king.
Totally going down there. There's a mic in my way. Oh, no, it's all good.
The throne room. Essential first thing in the morning.
Correct. So, just fixing my headset.
Very true love.
That's a big locked door.
All clear!
She called back to her uncle.
I've waited years for this moment. By all that's good in this world, I hope it's still locked.
Very bright.
Ha! The fools never figured it out.
He snickered. Uncle Argus then turned to Quill with a wink and a smirk, and plunged his blade
into the green-shelled mouse.
His sword was the key.
Sup, Strifer.
But the triumph soon faded as they descended into the eerie quietude of the secret chamber.
Please be safe.
Her uncle pleaded under his breath, with an air of unease Quill had never heard before. A voice barked back.
I'd retreat if I were you. Dark, dark magic afoot here. One whip of my wand and a swarm of undead wasps will skewer you alive.
Grocery prices. That's what's up.
Her uncle laughed.
Barnard, don't tell me all this time alone.
But my cat would fettle the pesky mouse.
I don't have undead wasps. Total bluff.
He chuckled.
My dear August, I can't believe it's really you!
Oh look, I'm getting things over here. Got those three things?
I'm so sorry, fretted her uncle. I tried to get back to you so many times. I just couldn't kill that vicious snake.
Their long-awaited embrace was cut short.
Argus!
Barnard panicked.
I feel the Reader's presence! The usurper followed you in!
No, Barnard! This is Quill, my next of kin and a twofold champion. They slayed Sawfog.
Holy whiskers on a weasel!
Barnard was stunned.
Tell me about it, Artful.
Oh,
got the daughter two tickets for next year at £180.
Mogwart tea, anyone?
Barnard spent hours recounting his years in hiding, protecting the King's Glass from the Arcane.
And with Sarfog dead, that winged tyrant will tear this castle apart. He knows one glass is here. Now two?
Must be the bottle from the last game.
This is bad. Very bad.
Not if Quill gets all five glass first,
said her uncle with a grin.
Madness, Argus!
Barnard replied.
Even a twofold cannot take on their army. Not with a warden forging screechers and scorchers and Arthur knows what.
Hogwash!
Uncle Argus retorted.
Quill can handle that bloated behemoth after she rallies the Sprite army. Don't you see? Once we join all the glass, there will be no Arcane. Even Vader will see it our way. She must.
We could unwrite them all,
Barnard mused.
But Argie, the truce states the glass must remain separate.
Truce be damned! We need the remaining glass to restore peace. But first, Quill must rally the sprites. It's the only way.
Not even the big band. 21 pilots grabbing young kids. Just about cover the cost of a tribute band to play at a backyard barbecue by the time you cover tickets.
Her uncle's belief in her and the reader swelled Quill's pride. They had a sprite army to inspire and the five glass to unite. And it all started with claiming the King's Glass.
Get back after.
Now, somebody worked hard on that pottery. I made her go standing, so be a better experience for her first proper gig. His name is Patrick Swayze.
Should I go up there? I think I should go up there first before going in there. Seems normal. That's where we were headed anyway.
No such thing.
Two down, three to go, thought Quill, excited by the adventures ahead. Barnard was clear. She'd find quick passage to the sprites through the Room of Realms.
The Room of Realms? I'm gonna guess it's this.
They make them in stadiums over here. If you're seated, it's a asterisk a hem asterisk show.
Not if it's fire show. Or even a sat show.
Holding chairs to make the circle fit WWE.
Ooh. That's cool. Oh, there's a microphone in the way. Damn it, get out of the way. Sup. Ooh. Yeah, baby.
Like the King's Guard of old, Quill now felt the history of every battle her uncle led.
I sincerely hope they filmed the first Slayer classics with folded seating arrangements.
She could almost hear her uncle's commands.
That was cool.
Quill could see the green glow of the Sprite Realm radiating from the doorway ahead.
You know the first thing I notice about this game, Neon?
What's that?
The screens are memorable.
Yeah, very true. Hey, look. That's the lead light glass things I was.
They've composed the individual screens.
Only sprites can cross here,
croaked an unseen voice.
I have the green glass. I'm your champion.
Oh, fine then.
The voice grumbled.
But no one here's calling you champion.
Yet.
Looks like a well-bathed rodent.
Ooh. Oh, hello.
A lot of things now. Just sort of blend together in a smoosh of unnamable place.
It was as if the castle of her people had been plucked from its roots and planted among the vibrant hues of the sprites.
This nicely composes the locations.
She marveled at the magic of it all as she hurried to rally the sprite army.
Okay. I'll get that at some point. Damn, that means over there needs water or something.
The height of your lawn clipping is immaculately consistent. Both games are super cute VR platformers. Not often VR gets this kind of quality game.
Yeah. That means I can't get back up.
For sure. VR has been struggling in fits and spurts to get going, being treated to novelty games.
Well, this is frog dude, toad dude.
Well,
yeah.
Croak the toad.
If it isn't the world's smallest snake slayer.
Starfog was only the beginning.
It's more willing creatives to take a leap into something meaningful and platform specific.
Impossible.
The toad scoffed.
Rootseer Veda, revered leader of the Mire Sprites and astute seer of the fates and patterns of nature's purview, does not take walk-ins.
Please, our fates depend on it. I need to speak with her.
And I need a nap. Fine. You're the champion. So prove it. Follow this little bug here. See where that leads. Then, by all means, come back here and walk right in. Now shoot.
Whoa, parkour.
Quill found the toad's behavior curious. But the sprite bud seemed eager to help her reach Veda.
It's the potato quest holding VR back, as much as it has pushed VR everything is cut down to fit on standalone HMDs above catch 22.
Scroll. Device, device, device. Sprite. Okay.
The money in sales just isn't there if you don't include quest.
Well, PSVR2 is getting PC support very soon, so maybe that'll change things. Not sure how well it's going to go, but... One. Okay. I feel like... I should be able to go. I don't know. What the hell? If I go down. Yeah, okay, alright.
Please consider liking the stream. It only costs a theoretical 1.4 calories.
Two. Okay. Just chill, Sprite dude. I'm not finished yet.
We see support sounds like Sony is trying on the plus side to widen the PSVR2 market, or if you're cynical, then washing their hands of it.
Well, I think it's to introduce more games for the headset. Where am I going? This way. Which means I can use other things, I guess. Maybe it's to sell all of the headsets they got in storage at the moment. Right, that's cool. Okay. Boom shakalaka. Oh, hello.
Why would you want more games if you have a bespoke platform? Unless you don't have the games for it.
Well, nobody's buying it, see? So that might be the way they're going. They have stock that they're not selling.
Selling your own HMDs, why would you devote any studio to make something that's not going to sell?
Okay. Where did that come from? You want me to do this?
Reader, the sprites have granted you the means to inspire growth in this world.
Yeah, this that means wisely, that.
And Quill's path will flourish.
Where's the mic? Sorry, there's a mic there. Fuck! Alright, give me a second, I have to move the mic a little bit. The wrong way. Wrong place. Okay. Is the audio still okay? Where is it? Yeah, okay. Should be okay. Parkour.
Personally, I'm hoping it revives PSVR. Foveated rendering is massive. I was pissed when Quest 3 didn't use it. It's super useful for VR cool. Sound is still good.
Awesome, thank you. It's a bit weird having a mic instead of a headset in VR. Didn't make that. Ah.
No walk-ins, huh?
Quill smirked to herself, recalling the toad's words. Now they could go back and make their own path to Veda.
No Man's Sky in VR yet, Neon.
Yeah, I have. It's pretty cool.
It looks amazing.
Yeah, it's awesome.
The best VR visuals I've ever seen.
I'm so glad they got the foveated rendering for that. It looks much better. I just get a bit, a little bit nauseous after a while, especially like driving the vehicles.
Vehicles can be rough. I fly mostly, then jetpack.
Jetpack, yeah. The only thing I don't like about that style is using just these sense, to do the flight control. That's a bit cumbersome. Still fun, but there's a mic here somewhere again.
You can grab the controls and fly proper.
Yeah, but it's odd when your hands are floating around. Just takes a bit to get used to, I guess. Ah! Bye, Mousy. Okay, so first off, you can go down there. You can go over there.
I'm keen to try out the ARC, but I'm just waiting for a second-hand unit in good condition to pop up. Brand new dead white pricey here.
You should talk to random, Stevie. But then again, I'm not sure. Are they not region-specific or what?
ATM is best play. People buy the music for an hour and that's about it. South Africa and Australia use the same region coding as far as I know.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Not region specific.
Yeah, definitely talk to random then. Although, then again, there's shipping, which is insane. Oh, there's a table there. So does this revert back as soon as I jump off? Yes, it does. Okay. Ooh, that's interesting. Ah, okay, that's even more interesting. You there, and then you.
Can he not handle the motion sickness?
No, he can't.
That's the big problem. Nobody wants to spend the time to build their VR legs. Enjoying the content. Please consider liking the stream. It only costs a theoretical 1.4 calories.
Okay. You're gonna need to come back. No, not there, idiot. There. Yeah, I know that's over there. So if you go there, you go up there. Go back here.
Some geeks will get it a week or two, some never all months of practice.
Oh, that's out, isn't it? I want to go this way first. What am I doing? Fuck. Start again, shall we? Fuck.
I'm the way round the green hell for my lad. Gets up and wants his PC back. That is all.
Later. Thanks for stopping in. Then you go up there. Fuck. I forgot there was a scroll over there.
Gaming, sim racing and or retro gaming content and chat with like-minded people. Join the Discord at https://discord.gg/affvvn4j6. Latters Erby.
See you later, Herb. Peace out.
All good, brother. Catch you in a bit.
Oh, I've done it again. Idiot. Getting ahead of myself. Yeah, I know, I'm getting to it. Just chill, mousy. Mike. Oh no. this is a boss fight or something. Dirt. Nothing hiding, okay.
They were almost back. Quill couldn't wait to see that crotchety toad's expression when they walked right up to Veda's throne.
Looks like you may be able to walk in and see Veda after all,
remarked the toad smugly.
Thanks for your help, toad.
Help a rodent?
He croaked with exasperation.
Never. Now go bother Veda if you must. I could use the entertainment.
Whoa.
Quill approached Veda's throne with the confidence of a champion.
Rootseer Veda, Sarfog is dead, she proclaimed. My reader and I stand before you now to ask for your help.
Yes, the winds carried swift word of your victory twofold,
Veda replied.
And for making safer our soil, we are grateful. We'd be honored to provide both you and Argus safe passage back to your home in the clearing.
Thank you,
Quill replied.
But Moss, we'll never be safe until all the forged armies are defeated. I have been chosen to safeguard the glass, and with the sprites fighting by our side, my reader and I will claim it all and end the Arcane.
Veda was wide-eyed at this news, seemingly in awe. But the awe was anger.
The glass cannot be joined!
Veda fumed.
We separated it for a reason! And now, some young, naive mouse dares to bring them together?
Quill was caught off guard, but kept her composure.
Times have changed!
Time is repeating!
Veda snapped.
The last one who dared to hold these five glass toyed with all our fates! So I will help you twofold. I'll help you to restore a vital balance. Give us back the green glass.
At the peace and prosperity our realms knew before the Cinder Knight, back when the glass was separate, Veda continued. It is your duty to keep the torched wings that dominate our skies from writing the end for us all.
Quill dug in.
My uncle Argus, commander of the King's Guard, entrusted me and my reader to restore peace. We will face the Arcane and take their glass. It's the only way.
Argus is gravely mistaken. Veda seethed.
Are you here to play God, reader?
She shouted to the sky.
Is that it? Do you think yourself wise enough to author our fates?
Yep.
Quill defended her partner.
We'll fight this war on our own if we have to.
And so you will. Let her pass,
Veda ordered her soldiers.
Then seal off every portal here.
I had hoped you wiser than Argus, child. I pray our fates remain our own.
As Quill headed back to the castle, the toad consoled her in his own prickly way.
Don't take it too hard. There's a lot going on that your tiny brain couldn't possibly comprehend. Stay safe, Furball.
The farther Quill walked, the worse she felt. Uncle Argus had believed in her, and she'd failed miserably.
That's the final bit, I think.
Messing with those stick-headed sprites. It's glass you need.
Skull.
And you'll find it right through this door. Crush the keeper, break the hex, and you're in. Follow me.
Something I need there first, I think. Wait.
Quill saw Durin, he was snapped up in the jaws of Sarfog. Yet, here he was, unscathed. What a wondrously strange creature, Quill thought, and hurried to catch up.
Thank you.
on, kid. Gotta move while he's still sleeping.
Just chill, I'm busy. Doing important shit. Okay, I'm ready.
The keeper lives inside that greenhouse, kid.
Adurin spun a gesture toward the shiny building in the distance.
Me? I wouldn't dare. But for a two-fold like you, quick business.
Something I need. Another power, looks like.
Quill wondered why Adurin was so skittish. But if his plan led to more glass, then she wouldn't have to return to her uncle empty-handed.
Ooh. Okay, let's go. What? Yeah. You okay? Ooh. You stuck? Okay. I knew it. Wait, no, down there. This way, I guess. Okay, to come back to this boat. Knew it. Boom shakalaka. Okay. That was cool.
As Quill reached the greenhouse, her excitement rose. It was spilling with beautiful and wild plant life. and the Keeper was hiding somewhere at the heart of it.
For more gaming, sim racing and or retro gaming content and chat with like-minded people, join the Discord at https://discord.gg/affbn4j.
Ah, I knew it. Ooh, okay, cool. I'm gonna prime you. Ah. Goose. Okay, we'll go up there first.
Dear reader, Quill grows swift and nimble, blessed by those who came before her. Do not let her passion surpass her means. We've come too far.
Jeez. Okay, that'll work. Oh, I had a Parkour.
Parkour.
Yeah, that was gonna happen. Up.
Hi, random.
Sup, random. Ah, fucking idiot. Do I have to start all over again? Yes. Oh, not quite, I think.
Colorful language, haha.
Boom shakalaka. Up! No! Fucking get up! Did I press the wrong button?
This could be the Keeper's Lair!
Thought Quill. If so, she'd need to find a way inside to break the hex.
Okay, bye.
cheating.
Sup, Eddie. Good day, mate.
Stardust.
Fucking. Yeah.
Enjoying the content. Please consider liking the stream. It only costs a theoretical 1.4 calories. I saw rain come down so heavy.
Only oh, really?
Lasted about 30 minutes, but wow.
Oh, wrong button. That was weird. Thank you. Oh, look. Oh. No. Right, that's better.
Just about to go food shopping with the Kraken. And it's afternoon spark time. Might do some spark practice.
Yeah, what? Yeah, okay. I agree. What the hell? What are you going that way for? Thank you. There's a table. Wait a minute. What the hell? Go away. Right. Let's reset. Oh. That way, go.
Gaming, sim racing and gore retro gaming content and chat with like-minded people. Join the Discord
no.
At https://discord.gg/affvvn4j6.
That'd be a greenhouse. Yo. Okay. Let's do it. What is this thing? It's a key. Let's go and use the key. There's the key.
Right, gotta fly. Enjoy your leaping rat game or whatever it is, lol. Catch you later, chaps.
See you, Eddie. Take care, dude. Thanks for dropping in, mate.
See you already. We'll see.
Our adrenaline rushed as the doors creaked open. Quill nearly hesitated, but resolved to crush the keeper, break the hex, and make her uncle proud.
Oh, boss fight. Okay. No. You punk bitch. There you are, finally. Do that. Ah, whoops. Whoops. Hey. You know he did. From parkour to breakdancing.
The keeper gone and the hex lifted. Quill could now return to that mysterious door in the castle where glass awaited.
Hey, I'm there, okay. Thank you. fuck. Fuck you. Can't avoid those when I'm too close. I thought I waited long enough, but I didn't. Obviously. Obviously.
Neon waving hand, waving hand, waving hand, oncoming fist.
Sup? What's cracking? Who are you?
Durin,
oh, J-Dog. Sup, dude?
Her school days.
Don't trust a starling, but if you do, count the whiskers left on you?
No.
Hi, J-Dog.
That wasn't quite right.
Not this again.
Stardust after a waving hand.
You did.
Sure what to do. Trust the starling and see if this little adventure led to more glass? Or return to her uncle and let him know she
failed before I go to bed. Have fun waving hand victory.
Cheers, dude. Thank you. Have a good night. Where am I supposed to go now? What the deuce? Obviously not here.
See you next time.
Ah, bitch. Ah, oh, it's hurt my nose today.
Adurin returned with delight.
I knew you would. Never a doubt. Come on, the hex is broken. You want more glass. I know just where to find it.
Can I go up here yet? I want to go up here. Yeah, let me in.
The sprites honored so few with their gifts. Hal of Hinderlong was the first.
This one?
Now, it was as if Quill could almost sense the vibrations of the roots coursing beneath her, too.
Maybe that's the problem. Our lenses are too close together. Hiya, parkour. Grace it. Have I not? I've been in there, haven't I? What's... I wanna know what that does. Nice, scroll up there. Oh, well, that makes things easier. The scroll, there's two scrolls over there. Oh no, that's a scroll and a doofalecky.
Take kindly to strangers.
Okay.
Or anyone, really. Better for me to set the stage.
Clean all the way? No, I don't clean all the way. Good.
No time to waste. I'll meet you on the mountainside.
Have a great time.
Quill stopped. Something didn't seem right. It was like the toad said. There was far more going on than she understood. She'd be empty-handed. But okay. Quill knew she had to return to the chamber to talk with her uncle before going any farther.
Where's her Fasha? Bitch. That was uncalled for.
Unexpected.
Yeah. Cue Act Two, I guess.
Thank you.
What is this, Hogwarts?
I'm so very sorry, reader. We've never seen a bond as strong as the one between you and Quill. And seeing it broken breaks us all. But you're still here, reader. And you're our last hope. With the Owl Tylan now in possession of four glass, there's only one left that evades him. Should he claim it, the world as we know it will end.
Come on, let's go. Give me the book.
The fate of Moss now lies in a tale that has turned quite cold to its readers. But it's here where the last glass resides. Long ago, a single creature held all five glass. And their reader became a god. You see, a reader with one glass can be a part of the story. But a reader with all five glass unlocks the means to rewrite the books of Moss, to author fate itself. And this reader had hate in their heart. Twofold became torched.
Give me a game idea.
The poor creature's will lost to the reader's own. And the world of Moss suffered a great unmaking. But the good creatures of Moss united together, seized the glass, and cast its omnipotent reader from their world forever.
That's me.
That any mortal survived that time was nothing short of a miracle. As time passed, champions rose and fell. Peace, however fragile, didn't come until the truce. The glass was divided between five realms, each vowing never to combine it again. But stories retold tend to fade with age, and history too often repeats. Which brings us to the Owl Tylan, who thought himself wise beyond all the creatures of Moss. Forsaken by his own for this hubris, Tylan found kinship with another outcast, a meddling starling named Adurin. Like all starlings, Adurin was immortal, but he loved the mess of mortality. How in their blink of life, mortals needed one another. So, anxious to impress his new friend, he helped Tylan steal his first glass from Rhyme Gold Complacent.
Join the Discord at https://discord.gg/affvvn4j6.
Such an act was ruled a crime among the Starling's own. With a punishment Adurin refused to accept. He was cursed to become that which he loved most. Mortal.
Oh,
and in 100 years and a day, he would die his final death. Desperate, Adurin revealed to Tylan the power of the five glass combined. Adurin hoped his twofold friend could use it to undo his own damnation. Tylan hungered to hold such domain, and so they stole another, then forged an army to steal it all. Then came the Cinder Knight, the night they would claim all five glass, but they failed. And enraged whispers befell Tylan's ears.
Adurin sabotaged us several times with that cursed starving. Let him die.
And the owl obeyed. Since then, Tylan has hexed and hunted every corner of Moss, and now only one glass eludes him. Lucky for us, the one who holds it hides herself well. But she vowed long ago never to answer the call of a reader.
Who that? Hey Dave, how you going, man? I haven't swore once. I'm just kidding.
Nothing made Sahima's weird brain boil more than the starving Adurin and his endless tricks. She tried to ignore him, but he kept rambling on about a twofold champion who'd killed the serpent Sarfog. I told you last time, if I saw you again, I'd kill you.
Ghostface? Well, where's the kid?
Not again. Fuck with him.
Yeah, good one.
She's been haunted by these monstrous readers her whole life.
Why me? Why me? This wasn't the plan.
What is that? Looks like gallium soup.
Ghost is in the snow. Quill's a no-show. But where'd the glass go? If that makes your glass the last, then I'll be right back.
Good riddance, thought Sahima as she watched the starthing buzz off. But now she needed to shake this vile reader.
I'm helping. I didn't do anything. Totally helping.
It was no use. There was no escaping this one. You're not welcome here, reader.
Don't care.
I work alone.
Come on.
Chills spread down Sahima's spine. Tylan and the Arcane were tearing Moss apart.
What the hell?
Of the Cinder Knight. Maybe worse. There would be no hiding.
This would be sick, like, for an RPG. Like a proper full-scale RPG.
Had to fight, even if that meant falling into this reader's hands.
Ooh. Yeah. Boom.
Well, this day just keeps getting better. Sahima grumbled to herself. We Arcane were closer than ever. She'd need to work fast.
Lucky I knew that was her. That's ice. Oh, there's a mic there. That's what happens, eh? See that? What does that mean? Okay, I got it. Now you can do the slow clap. That was the wrong button.
Sahima hated using this path. It was here where she promised her mother she'd protect the glass with her life and never let a reader tempt her. Vow she intended to keep.
Okay. Guess I'm going that way. I'm covering cords. Hang on. There we go. Someone over there, right? No? Okay. Oh, hi, rabbit. What am I supposed to do with that? I guess I'll do that. What? Fuck. Damn you. Okay. Sick music. Ah. Right, where are we going? Big castle.
Sahima was shocked to find the Arcane
gaming, sim racing, and more retro gaming content in chat with like-minded people.
Perfect timing, Stream Elements, you idiot.
https://discord.gg/rf4j6.
Enemy. Oh, it's one of you again. Yo, yo. Who that?
Stardust Unicorn.
Oh, Graham. G'day, mate. How are you? Oh, look over there.
Hi, Graham.
This thing needs to go. Thank you. Aha! I guess.
If Graham, how's it going, bro?
Oh, talk about a reach, God. Boom! Perfect shot. Yeah, baby. I'm watching you. Well, if they increase the area, I've got a lot of reaching to do, and it's a bit annoying when this all happens all the time. It's kind of immersion breaking. Psych. Fuck you. Oh, that's where you came from. Okay, cool.
Durin sprung maniacally from the castle depths.
Quill's down there. Somewhere. Follow me.
Last time I followed you, I went the wrong way. And then I had to come back here. Better not be leading me astray again.
Great.
Sahima grimaced at the sight of the starling.
I should have expected to find you here.
Bonk.
So what? I go down there, and you buzz off, and then all the real trouble comes? Get the message, bugger. No one wants you here.
If I were you, I'd be nicer to me. Just find her already.
Sahima hated to do anything close to what Adurin wanted.
To get there.
For all I know, this could be an elaborate trap set by that wretched starling. She thought. But if the champion who slayed Sarfog was really in the castle depths, together, maybe they could fix all this.
So where am I going? I'm going this way, I don't care. That looks like something. What is that? Should I go up there? Did the stupid thing go up there? Wait a minute, who are you? Going the wrong way, I blame Eddie. You again. Crikey. That shit looks cool. Sick. Fully sick. What? I'm going this way. These things look like they need power or something. Or a hammer. I need to smash them with a hammer. Thing. Yep. Okay.
Sahima heard something echo from the depths below. She inched her way to the edge to get a better look.
Oh.
After a jolting drop, Sahima was met by a blade. I'm a friend, she assured, offering her chakram.
A friend would have thrown a rope,
the stranger countered.
From the wreck I've seen up there, you're better off down here.
You're alone then?
Sahima nodded as the stranger relented her blade, unable to see the towering reader.
We defeated Sarfog and countless Forge soldiers, but then that owl. I lost everything. My best friend and my uncle Argus.
This was Quill? The champion Adurin had babbled on about? But she was so small and unassuming. Wait, you slayed Sarfog? Blurted Sahima, unconvinced.
Yes, my reader and I did.
A reader helped you? Sahima couldn't hold back.
They don't belong in our world.
She could feel the piercing energy from the reader as she spoke.
Where I come from? We learn never to be tempted by the power of those monsters.
Monsters? No! We were twofold!
Quill defended.
They were big when I needed to be bigger. Strong when all was stacked against me. You're wrong about them, and we're wasting time. I've got to finish my uncle's plan.
Sahima had never heard anyone speak of a reader in that way. As if they were one in the same. Like family. Sahima's curiosity was piqued. Tell me then. What's this plan of yours?
To end the Arcane once and for all,
said Quill with chilling intensity.
As soon as I can climb out of here, I'll go straight to the Foundry and crush the Warden of the Forged Army. Then I'll face that owl, avenge my uncle, and take back the glass he entrusted me to protect.
Sahima felt stirred by young Quill's confidence. If she and the reader were truly twofold, then they were the only chance to save Moss from Tylan.
And you plan to do this alone? Asked Sahima.
Barnard may still be in the chamber beneath the throne, Quill revealed.
Barnard the Unbreakable is alive?
Sahima knew then what she had to do. Her burden could be their savior. And as she threw Quill the winter glass, Sahima shaped her mother's dying words. A reader's will over moss falls solely on the one they've chosen.
Hey, Arnold.
So don't mess this up.
Oh, so bright.
That plan of yours? Count me in.
Okay.
I'm Sahima, by the way. Keep the shotgun. I'll find the mage while you take down the warden.
Bye.
I have this game, it's so good.
Quill studied the glass. It wasn't hers, or the king's glass. It shone.
War gaming, sim racing, and more retro gaming content in chat with like-minded people. Join the Discord at https://disc.
Stream elements, I'm gonna fire you.
Is it really you? Where have you been?
Quill realized then how little she knew about readers. What she did know was she had missed her friend very much.
Deactivate stream elements or something.
Maybe.
Quill approached her uncle's grave while the mysterious warrior paid her respects.
I think I can, deactivate some of the commands.
I didn't know Commander maybe. Argus. Only his legend. Quill felt the impossible weight of leaving her uncle for the last time. The only way to truly honor him would be to finish his plan with her reader.
Let's do it.
Anything was possible.
Quill had spent her days ruminating over every detail her uncle and Barnard had planned. Now she was finally free to start again and hunt the warden who toiled somewhere in these depths.
group 2 race CXO see how many new GT1s are used.
Oh no, not down there. Oh my god. Yeah, I know. I can see it. I need... Oh. Okay. Cool.
Warden had spent years transforming these caverns into a foundry to forge steel soldiers and weapons of war. And her uncle had been adamant. To reach the Owl Tylan, the Warden must be defeated first.
Crikey. Yeah, I tried that already, didn't I? Hitting the mic. Seriously, thought that was too high. No, up. Thank you. By the power of Grayskull. Wrong button. Oh, been playing for that long. Crikey. Ooh, that looks pretty cool. I have to go up there. Need weapons.
Time see my mum especially, since my bed is burning fire rolling on the floor laughing. Pretty decent song watching it on YouTube.
cool, cool. Where am I going? See you later, Dave.
Looks like a decent game.
Yeah, it's pretty fun. Good puzzles.
Cheers, Stardust TC.
Dearest reader, here lies the hammer of Cariel. The legends forgot how the hammer fed on his wrath, until only fury drove his heart. But if you can lift Quill up from the weight she carries, she'll find the strength to hold.
Yes, hammer. Yo, what's up? No! Damn. Okay, I got it sussed. You. Tangled up again. What's going on? Oh, okay. So you... Oh, I can't grab him. Ah, okay. Oh, okay. Wait. I'll get it. Yeah, come on, loser. No, I didn't want to do that. Such a knob. Now I can hit that thing. Oh. Shit. Hammer parkour. See that shit?
Quill could feel the warden below her. She had to find a way down.
There's a way down. But first, oh wait, this one. I don't even know if I should be up here yet. Should I be up here yet?
Gaming content and chat with like-minded people. Join the Discord at https://discord.gg/affvvn4j6.
It said I need to go down. Let's just go down. Hiya! Come back after we've done what I was supposed to do. Boom. Looks like we're going up. No. Go this way first. Yeah. Boss? Boss. Aha! A key. Whoa. That was cool. Go, go, go. I should stay on that. Get up there. I think I want to go that way first. That's what I'd be thinking. Something around here, right? No? Ooh. It's close. Right, so let's get this figured out. Thank you. Oh. I'm going up there. Oh. I should have thought about that. This way first. I think it's three. One, two. That one's only two. Run, 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 run! Uh-oh. Key number two. My controllers last for this boss fight. Thank you.
recalled her uncle's heated retelling of the Cinder Knight.
That barbaric, war-obsessed warden blindsided me, then smashed my whole battalion. What I wouldn't give for another go. I'd crush him myself.
Quill wanted nothing more than to deliver that justice.
Let me just check this controller situation. They will die at any moment. So, I will save it. That's autosave, okay. Cool. Alright, let's go. Yeah, we got this.
Seems a little unfair, look.
A little. Boom. That's what you get. That's what you get. Ooh, that was close. Uh-oh. Shit just hit the fan. Keep pressing the wrong button there. We're holding the button down too long. How's he supposed to fly with those wings? Ridiculous. He's got a hot hammer. Ah. These measly things killed me. Shit. I think I've got to hit his hammer with this. But it's very, very quick. Maybe not. Ugh. Should have done it then.
Gaming content and chat with like-minded people. Join the Discord at https://discord.bfbn4j6.
Quill could almost hear Uncle Argus in her mind, overjoyed knowing the Warden had finally been defeated. Now she had to face Tylan and finish the plan.
Quill knew where to go. To the top of the castle, closest to the skies. That's where she'd find that murderous owl.
I'm gonna have to call it there, guys, because my controller's gonna die any second. I'd be reckoning. So, thanks for joining, hanging out. Oh, I got a sore back. I shall see you all tomorrow. What's tomorrow? Monday? For some more, whatchamacallit?
See you all next time.
Horizon Zero Dawn tomorrow.
TC buddy.
Cheers. Wrong button. Let me. What am I doing? stop. Broadcast. Okay, alright, bye everyone.